Hi there, Abhik here. So in this video we'll be learning how to upload files without a model field in Django, as well as how to download PDF files from Django backend. And it is frontend agnostic, so you can use a REST API as well, and these tricks will work. So let's do that. So make sure that inside your settings.py you should have the static root, media root, as well as media URL. And inside the urls.py, or within your projects folder, that is the folder where it is settings.py and wsgif.py is also present, you should add this green code. Okay, so the plus static and plus static for media URL, so that it can serve the static content. Okay. Inside this upload file view function, this is the view obviously. So if the request is post, then we will upload the file, otherwise we will just render the form. So if equal to request.files file, now this file variable is the inside the request is contains the file, and if s equal to the file system storage, make sure you import it correctly. Now when we have already initialized the file system storage, then we will use the file name and comma ext to split the file's name and extension, and then we will save the file. Make sure that we are sending the file name first and then the file in fs.save, and file URL, you can get the URL as well as you can get the size, fs.size, fs.url for them respectively, and then you can render the request as well as with the HTML and the context you can pass the file URL as well as file name, ext and size as you wish. Those are not compulsory, but you can do that. I am doing this for present demonstration, and otherwise we will render the blank HTML without any context. So when that is done, set the URL. Now the path will be upload file with capital F, and I will also import the views from dot views, and then I will set the urls.py inside the core directory of our project. So inside the upload file HTML, I am having a form with action as /\ upload file. Method will be post obviously, and ink type will be multipart form data, \form data. Now the ink type is very important for getting the request.files, otherwise we will get request.post, not request.files. And I have also passed the CSRF token. Now for getting request.files file, we need to have an input with the name file. And you can also have the ID file, otherwise we won't get this request.files file. So after button submit, we are also having the ahrf tag with file URL and file name. Remember, we were returning it from our views. Also, now let's upload a PDF and upload. And when uploading, we are returning this URL with the name. So if I press this URL, you can see that the PDF is opening. So this is uploading, upload is working fine, completely fine. However, this PDF is opening, it is not downloading. So also let's try another file with another file format. So this is a pptx format, duplicate slides. So if I try to open this duplicate slides, on pressing the link, it is downloading. Now let's after downloading, let's open it. And if I open it with WPS Office, which I use in my computer, so it is working fine, and you can open it with any other Office app as well. So let's try to upload the PDF once again, and if we are trying to upload it, it is again opening on our browser. Now this is not a problem for this website where Django is rendering the HTML, but it can be a problem when you are using REST framework. So let's address that issue. So we need to fetch the file's given URL, and after getting the file, we need to create an object URL for that file object, and then we can download it. So we need to have a tag, anchor tag, which has a download attribute, and we will set the href to the object URL, and we will click that anchor tag within the JavaScript. So all this will happen within one click, so that we can download a PDF file. So here we can have a div with onclick, or which will have a download function, which will call a download function, and text content will be download. And inside the download function, we will pass the first argument as file URL, and also the second argument will be the file name. Now both of these are necessary, so we need to pass this. We are creating this function download with URL and name, and then we will fetch the URL, and then we will get the async race, and after that we need to constant dfile will be the await race.blob. Now this race.blob is the file, and after that we need to get the var blob URL. Now this blob URL will get the object URL of the file. So window.url and window.url.createObjectURL exists, only then we will create the window.createObjectURL with the dfile, that is the file itself. Otherwise we will use window.webkiturl to create object URL. Now we will create the a tag which I will name temp link. So the document.create element a have a display of none, and also the href for this temporary link will be the blob URL that we get after creating the object URL. So this is the object URL actually, and we will set the attribute download to the name of the file that is passed. However, some browsers have the download to be undefined. So for that, we need to set attribute target equal to blank, underscore blank. We will append this temp link to the body and then we will click it. So now this file will be downloaded. However, after 200 milliseconds, we need to remove this child, as of now it is displaying is none, but this is already present in the HTML. So we need to remove this child. Also after that, we need to revoke the object URL. So once we create the object URL, we also need to revoke the object URL. Let's upload a file now. So I am uploading this software engineering Rajib Mal PDF, and then after I upload it, you can see that on pressing the link, it is still opening on the browser, and then when we press the download, we can also download this file. So let's open this file, and you can see that it is opening as a file instead of opening it on server. So it's working absolutely fine. So also let me show you how if you open this file in the folder, then it is actually downloaded inside the folder, and you can also open it with WPS Office. So let me open it with WPS Office, and you can open it with MS Word or any other desktop app or any other app with which you open your Office files normally. So you can see that the PDF file is opening and it's working absolutely fine. Also, you can do one more thing, that is, if you don't want to do this hassle, then you can use the JavaScript file download library, and you can use it very easily. So only one line is required for that instead of all this line. So let me show you how to use it. So after getting the file from fetching it, then we can pass this to the file download function, and you need to require it. Obviously, then you can send the file and also the name. So thank you guys for watching this video, and those who have already subscribed to my channel, thank you for supporting me. Thank you very much.